Yep, not everything on the timeline is quite what it seems.
So here we have a fake LeBron James announcing he wants to be traded away from the Lakers, a fake George Bush saying that he missed killing Iraqis, Donald Trump claiming to give his full endorsement to Joe Biden.
And corporate accounts are copying it too.
Nintendo posted this photo of Mario pointing the middle finger.
His arms dealer Lockheed Martin apparently having a sudden attack of conscience. BP owning up to its role in destroying the planet. Pepsi admitting defeat in the cola wars. And pharmaceutical company Eli Lilly deciding to dole out free insulin.
Sending its stock sliding 4.5%.
So, what happened? Basically, Twitter launched its premium service, Twitter Blue, including a verification process that involves no actual verification.
Some users began to abuse the service and impersonate athletes, brands, celebrities, even Musk himself.
To limit the damage, free speech advocate Musk has gone on a banning binge. Coincidentally, the phrase Space Karen is trending. Ironically, charging users $8 a pop for a blue tick was meant to raise some much-needed revenue.
Even if every blue checkmark paid $8 a month, it is very small money compared to what they're currently getting from their big advertisers.
And Musk's latest missteps sent advertisers scrambling for the exit.
This is all about risk. They're working with someone who is inherently unpredictable, so they're pulling out.
It's not so much the concern of, you know, the hellscape right now, it's the chaos.
Musk has admitted that Twitter's on the brink.
We just definitely need to bring in more cash than we spend. If we don't do that, and bankruptcy is not out of the question.
But he seems to have developed a nasty knack for making a bad situation worse.
You fire half the staff, you get rid of safety protocols, and things start to break down on the platform.
So, in trying to save Twitter, will Elon Musk destroy it?
If Musk can't raise the $1 billion in interest that he owes on Twitter year on year, it could head to bankruptcy, which would be a really tragic end for one of the most important platforms that the web has had.
Save me. It is such a spectacular bin fire, but I can't look away, and I can't help but liken Elon Musk to Regina George in Mean Girls during the food court fight. It's just so chaotic. But one artist who's had a very strange side effect of all of this, because with the verification processes now, verified users can't change their display names. And okay. Doja Cat, who is a very well-known American singer-songwriter, she's got 5.5 million followers on Twitter alone. She had her handle as Christmas, simply as Christmas. She's begging Elon Musk, why can't I change my name on here? Elon, please, I don't want to be Christmas forever. So they allowed her the space to change her name, and then she goes and changes it to Elon Musk. But then Elon had the final say and changed her name to Fart, and now she can't change it back. So now we know Doja Cat as Fart.
He's got a sense of humour, but do you think it's a little bit misplaced?
It's like excessive troll energy. Like, yeah. There's trolling and then there's Elon Musk-level trolling.
You are loving this. You are loving seeing this descend into a big
Lisa,
fire.
Lisa, I would never say I told you so.
It's interesting, because you're not on Twitter, Hamish.
No,
that does mean that people like me could register a Hamish McDonald account and do all sorts of mischief in your name. For $8 a month, you know?
Don't listen.
You go for your life. You're already being cancelled. Yeah.
Good luck.
I told you it's not a lifestyle.
A lot of tweets about Hamish's lifestyle are coming up. No, it's not. We need to stop joking about this. It's not.